Hello, it's Scott Manley here, and today I'm finally looking at the story mode of The Long Dark. The Long Dark is a game that I've been excited for a long time. I was a Kickstarter backer on day one. The story is that there has been a massive solar flare, something even bigger than the Carrington event. This has essentially rendered all electronics and electrical hardware useless. The world has now lost the ghost in the machine that powered it, and I am stuck in the distant north with no clues how to survive, basically. Episode 1, Do Not Go Gentle. Mackenzie and Dr. Greenwood are separated after their plane crashes deep in the northern Canadian wilderness. Struggling to survive, Mackenzie explores the small town of Milton, where he begins to understand the scope of this quiet apocalypse. Okay, let's get going. So obviously I've played Sandbox and Challenges before. This is going to be a different experience. This is going to have narrative, and it'll probably start out with something like a tutorial. Oh man. I'm guessing there's been a plane crash.
Yes. Well, what? What did you say? I can barely hear you. All I can hear is my heart beating its last.
Don't let the snow break you.
Don't let the snow break me. I won't. Oh, it's so cold. I'm already getting goosebumps. What happened? Oh my god. Wow. Wow. That was a genuine surprise. Okay, remove. Oh my god. Ah. Brings back memories to my childhood. Something I did stupidly. Oh man, what happened?
I need to find some shelter from this wind.
Oh man, look at this. Look at that solar wind. It's a shame I can't just stand next to this warm stuff and keep myself up.
Guess I'm stuck in some kind of ravine.
That's useful for starting a fire. Some sticks. Oh, look, here's some supplies here. Oh, cardboard box. Let's not do that right now. First aid kit. Come on. I'm hurt. Let me see. Bandage. Antibiotics. Bandage. Okay. Basically, you know, it's thing about first aid is important and will keep your ass alive. But right now, such thing. Ah, some wood here. Ah. Use the campfire option in the radial menu. You'll need all the fixings, fire starter, tinder, fuel, and a bit of luck. Because frequently you start a fire and it doesn't work. Okay, campcraft. Build that there. And I guess I'll use... I guess I'll use birch thing and cedar firewood. Yes. Come on. I'm presuming these all have different chances of success attached to them. And, you know, if you balance these right, you will maximize your fire skill. And of course, then you'll get more skill making fires because the game does track these wilderness survival skills. Speaking of survival skills, I'm kind of concerned about those bones there. They're not human, but... whatever, I'm not sure if those are the remains of something that got eaten, and whatever ate it probably doesn't care whether it's human or not. Okay, so before I do anything, let's apply this bandage. So that will help with my hand. Yes, I'm not losing blood anymore. Okay, what else is going on? Survival of the fittest. Oh, you have a bleeding wound. Great, I fixed all that.
That's all I have in me. Need to lay down before I fall down.
Oh, that's interesting. Now, normally in sandbox mode, you know, that would just continue to burn. But I guess in narrative mode, it automatically takes you to the next day. Okay,
so a way to melt some snow.
So I need to. So it's basically tutorial mode. So we gotta find some. We gotta make stuff to build a fire.
Better see what I can use.
So it seems like most of this is a tutorial for people that have previously played the game, of course, and just skipping forward.
Working on a hell of a storm last night.
Wow.
Blew that tree clean over.
I see an animal carcass. See that? There's the crows up there. Oh, hey, and there's stuff up here. Yeah, there's an animal carcass, but there's also...
Astrid's bag.
Her bag. What's in it? I don't know what the code is.
Locked.
Yeah, it's not like we couldn't break it open, though. Oh, story!
Jackrabbit Remote Transport, Mackenzie speaking.
Well, slow down, Morgan. What are you talking about? It's okay, Maureen. I've got it from here.
Hello, Will.
What are you doing here?
It's been a while, I know.
Yeah. Years. I haven't heard from you since...
I know. And I wouldn't be here if it weren't important.
Well, what brings you... I mean, are you sick?
No, not me. But I need to get to someone who is.
Right. So you're still a doctor?
Yes, I'm still a doctor.
I thought that after... Why are you here?
I need your help. There's an isolated community in the northern part of Great Bear. Someone there is very sick.
Great Bear? There's nothing there anymore. Not since...
I know. But I have to get there.
Still trying to save the world, huh?
Somebody has to.
What's that supposed to mean?
Mackenzie... Will... I didn't come here to fight about the past. I need a pilot to take me somewhere remote. Someone who won't ask too many questions. Someone I can trust.
Wait, questions? Astrid, are you in trouble?
Are you gonna help me or not?
What's in the case?
See, there's that thing about no questions, remember?
What's in the case, Astrid?
No questions.
Look. The weather out there is bad. Bad. But it's getting worse. You walk in here after years. I could have been dead. You could have been. And then you show up and you want me to just risk my life flying into the middle of the great northern nowhere to deliver you in some mystery metal case to some remote wilderness outpost. All because you walked in here and asked me to?
Yes.
Astrid. You can't bring him back.
This isn't about that.
I know how hard it's been.
No. You don't know, Mackenzie. You don't know anything.
You don't think I feel it too?
Are you gonna take me or not? The longer I wait, the worse it'll get. Damn it. I don't have time for this.
Wait. The worse what will get? Why do I have a feeling you're not talking about the weather?
Because I'm not.
Throw your bags in the plane. I'll get started on pre-flight. Better buckle up tight, because it's going to be a rough ride.
That is some pretty gnarly weather to be flying in. Okay, so Yeah, the scripting, I don't know, this, I heard they're making this into a movie now, but I'm presuming they're going to, you know, not have the actors.
Astrid was ready to die for it. I hope she hasn't already died for it.
Oh no, mystery. Yeah, I don't know, it felt like they might have not recorded those performers in the same room at the same time. No, I can't get into that backpack, okay. Ah, Will's coat. Great, let's put my coat on. Coats are important, obviously. So I can throw this on now. Oh, it's frozen though. Might have to melt it. But it'll just reach. Oh, come on. Oh man. Rose hips, mother's natural painkiller, yes! Of course, harvest the rose hips. I'll take some of these. Oh, there's some more wood there, excellent. That'll help my fire situation. I'll have to probably start another fire, but at the very least. Oh, there, prepared rose hips. Yes, that's what I gotta do. That's what I have to do. I'm hammering the rose hips in an anvil, obviously. Now I go to the campfire and prepared rose hips. Cook them. Make myself some sweet, sweet, sweet rose hip tea, which will slake my thirst. So now I have a nice warm cup of rose hip tea, which will dull the pain and make everything seem better. Ah, sprained ankle. It's okay.
May as well rest up. No telling what tomorrow will bring.
Oh, no telling what tomorrow will bring. Tomorrow will bring day 5. Climb again. Basically, there's only certain parts of the thing that you're supposed to be able to climb on.
I think I'm gonna make it.
Come on, let's get up this slope here. To carefully pick my route.
Getting near the top.
I can make it. I can do it. I'm sure because the story demands it.
Ugh. Finally made it.
Oh look, there's some more bits of plane here. Man, I must have hit the ground really hard if there's bits over here. I guess maybe plane detached or aerodynamic surfaces detached. Whoa! I'm amazed I'm still alive.
I sure hope Astrid's not in there.
I see you're still wearing it.
Huh? Wearing what?
Your ring. Our ring.
Oh. Yeah. I just forgot to take it off.
I wear mine too.
Why?
Memories, I guess.
I thought you wanted to forget.
Not all of it.
Look. I should have looked for you.
It's okay. I've kept busy. I've moved on.
You sure? Because this all seems pretty familiar. You still working with that researcher, Doctor? What's his name?
No. No, I'm not working at the center anymore.
Well, then where?
I'm working on my own. Freelance, you could say.
Freelance doctor? That sounds legit.
I don't question your life choices, Mackenzie. Plenty of things you could be doing besides hanging out in your dad's old plane and drinking in the daytime.
Hey, we had a lot of good times in this plane. And it's under control.
I know, okay? I'm not here to fight, really.
I think about him all the time, you know?
I know you do.
But
I did. The choice I made. I did it for us.
You don't have to. Let's just not...
No. It's important that you hear this. There's things I need to
Mackenzie,
say.
Mackenzie, not now. There's...
Just let me tell you.
Will, shut up for a second. Something's wrong.
That is not good.
What's going on?
Power's gone. Whole electrical system looks fried.
Shit! What's happening?
No power means we're going down. Hold tight.
Will?
Oh!
There must be signs of Astrid around here somewhere.
So this is chapter 2 already now, right? So first of all, we've got ourselves out of the thing. Let's grab some stuff. Let's look for anything.
Not sure which of us looks worse. Poor girl.
Oh, man.
This isn't how things were supposed to end.
Poor thing. You were once a glorious soaring bird. No. Oh, I thought that was a gun for a second. Oh, beef jerky. Hallelujah. Got some food. Orange soda. Sweet. It's probably frozen by now. Some wood, more cloth. If I can get a sewing kit, I can fix my clothes, which would be really helpful. Oh, some more clothes here. Down vest and some socks. Because apparently, let me see what my socks... apparently, yeah, I can wear an extra pair of socks. I'm going to wear these right now. They will... Oh, I think I need to thaw this out when I'm... Will's coat. I was wearing that next to the fire. I would have thought it would have warmed up by now. Not a good sign. Maybe I need to take that to the fire. Although, you know, I think it would be in the action menu when you were looking at the fire, right? Okay, so I don't see anything here. Oh, what's that? Signs of Astrid. How about something that...
passed through here. Not in a hurry.
Walking through the snow can get tiring, but sometimes you have to run. Burned out campfire. Firewood! Well, if it's Astrid, then she left her beef jerky behind. Maybe she's a vegetarian. Which is not the best thing to be when you're up here and the only thing to eat is meat. Okay, gonna try this again. Oh, look, I hit it! And it didn't die! Damn it! Get close. Yes! Yes! Hallelujah! Yes! Food! Excellent, okay. That will be useful to carry around.
There must be a way to get up there.
Huh. There we go. I may be freezing, but I have a rabbit now in my hands. I'm hoping, since there's another dead thing, I'm hoping it's not a person. Follow the birds. And it's another deer. God, they had me chasing a rabbit, but I could have been... Oh, I can harvest the gut and the hide. Yes. Let's do this. Let's just harvest everything. We have time still left in the day. Oh, it's getting cold now. I gotta start worrying about frostbite. And it is starting to get cold. Occasionally, you need to learn how to crouch. And a skill... which has never been seen in video games prior to this, so they had to tell you. I mean, I imagine that there are some people that might have never played a game that required you to crouch, but you know, it's good for them. Good for them for assuming that, or not assuming that everybody knew how to play games. So yeah, let's just leave that there. That's like about an hour of the game that I played. I've obviously cut it down for you all. Yeah, so the game is looking great. I mean, it's still the same great game. We have this first section, which is mostly tutorial. I thought the acting would be a lot better. To be fair, I think it more sounds like a bunch of well-acted lines that have been recorded completely separately. So, you know, it can be hard to be an actor when you haven't got someone else to act off of. Anyway, yeah, like, Long Dark, it is finally available for all those that have been waiting, and I'm quite enjoying it. Until next time, I'm Scott Manley. Fly safe.